function, graph the rational function. Before we solved this equation 1 over x plus 2 plus 3, but we solved with respect to the reciprocal parent function 1 over x. But now, for example, if we have 3x plus 7 divided by x plus 2 and we use the long division, we are going to get this function here, 1 over x plus 2 plus 3. So we get this form. But now I'm going to solve the same problem what we did before, but I'm solving from this perspective. So if we have f of x is equal to 3x plus 7 divided by x plus 2. So let's go and let's try this way here. But first let me find some key features here. Let me find the vertical asymptote. So the vertical asymptote here is if I'm taking the denominator x plus 2 and we equate it with 0. And if we are equating with 0, x plus 2, then when we are solving, x is going to be equal with the minus 2. So this is the vertical asymptote. Because we found the vertical asymptote, we can draw here x is minus 2. Let me draw here x minus 2. So we are drawing here the vertical asymptote. So vertical asymptote is x is equal to negative 2. And now, second thing, we are looking for horizontal asymptote. So the horizontal asymptote, what is the horizontal asymptote? We already know here if we are taking the degree of numerator, of the polynomial in numerator is 1. So let me say the degree is n is equal to 1. If we are looking for the polynomial in denominator, the degree here is 1. So m is equal to 1. So because the degree is 1, we take in the leading coefficient here of the upper polynomial in numerator and the leading coefficient in denominator, which is 1. And 3 divided by 1 is 3. So this is the horizontal asymptote, y is equal to 3. And now I'm going here to 3, and I'm going to draw the horizontal asymptote in the Cartesian system. And let me write here. So this is a horizontal asymptote, which is y is equal to 3. But in this case now, we are going to find the intercepts and to see where it lies the function. First of all, let's find the x-intercept and y-intercept. X-intercept is going to be, so let's find x-intercept. So x-intercept here is, if I'm taking the numerator here, and y is equal to 0, okay? If I'm taking the numerator, so I'm taking a shortcut. I'm taking numerator here because it's in the form of the fraction. 3x plus 7 and I equate with 0. And this way I can find one shortcut, how to find the x-intercept. And if I'm solving this equation, it's going to be x will be equal to the minus 7 divided by 3. When you solve it, it's a minus 7 divided by 3. And minus 7 divided by 3 is a negative 2 point something. So the function is going to be, is here somewhere. Let's say here is the x-intercept. And if we're looking for the y-intercept here, let me look for the y-intercept. Okay. For the y-intercept. And now I am making this equation 3 times 0, so let me write here y is going to be equal. So instead of the x, I'm plugging 0 here. 3 times 0 is a 0, and is a plus 7. Okay, this side, and the other side is going to be 0 plus 2. 0 plus 2 is a 7 divided by 2. So y is equal to 3.5. So it looks like it's 3.5. 7 divided by 2 is 3.5. So I'll take here with this. Or 7 over 2. 7 over 2 is 3.5 is here somewhere. It's here. Y-intercept. And now if I'm looking now how to graph the function here. I know the function is going to be this intercept. And because this is an intercept here, it's going to intercept in this form. And I know it's going to be very, very close, closer to the asymptote, because every time the end behavior and the asymptote goes very, very close to each other. And same thing is going to be with the asymptote on the top here, is going very close. So the graph of the function is going to look in this way. And same thing with the with this side here. Here is the intercept. The graph has to go here. If it has to go here, it means on the top side is going very close to the asymptote, and down the end behavior of this function here is going very, very close to the asymptote. So this is a graph of the function. And if we are looking for the domain of this function, to put some extra thing, the domain is going to be from minus infinity to minus 2. But minus 2 is not included, and its union from minus 2 to infinity. So this is the domain of the function, to infinity. If we are looking for the range of the function, let me add and adjust the range here. The range is going to be from minus infinity to 3. From minus infinity to 3. The range union from 3 to infinity.